everyone. Welcome to Talent Battle. Today, in our group discussion series, we will be talking about the impact of COVID-19 on the Indian economy. As usual, we will be having four parts: the introduction, overall impact of COVID-19, positive outcomes, and then the conclusion. Now first, let's go to the introduction. The COVID-19, that is the coronavirus disease of 2019, was first identified in Wuhan city of China in December 2019. Till now, approximately 9.76 million people are affected by it, and the count is ever increasing. There have been more than 4 lakh deaths worldwide due to this pandemic. The spread of COVID-19 in India. The cases in India have also shot up sharply and have crossed 5.09 lakhs as on 27 June 2020. The Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR, expects the corona-infected people to reach its peak in the November now, as various preventive measures like lockdown, social distancing, frequent washing of hands, wearing masks and PPE kits have delayed the spread of coronavirus in India. This has given more time to the country to make proper medical arrangements and preventive measures to fight the pandemic. Effect of COVID-19 on the businesses. According to the survey, COVID-19 is having a deep impact on the Indian businesses. The coming months' jobs are at high risk because firms are looking for some reduction in the manpower. Further, it is added that already COVID-19 crisis has caused an unprecedented collapse in the economic activities over the last few weeks. The COVID-19 and the Indian economy. On March 27, 2020, the Reserve Bank of India joined the big fight with a host of measures aimed at minimizing the damage from COVID-19. The Reserve Bank of India's Governor, Mr. Shashikanta Das, had announced a series of measures including policy rate cuts to bolster economy in the wake of COVID-19 menace. Sharing that the large part of major global economies are likely to be heading towards recession, the RBI governor stated that the economic recovery for India in 2020 would be very slow. COVID-19 is not just affecting the health of the people, but also economies of many countries including India. So, the topic impact of COVID-19 on Indian economy is widely discussed. Now, let's look at the overall impact of COVID-19. A notified disaster. Government of India as well as the state governments are treating and monitoring the situation closely to control the coronavirus pandemic. The Ministry of Home Affairs has decided to treat COVID-19 as a notified disaster. This will enable the states to spend a large chunk of funds from the State Disaster Response Fund to fight the pandemic. The GDP. The revised gross domestic product estimates for India downwards by 0.2 percentage points for the fiscal year 2020 to 4.8% and by 0.5% for the fiscal year 2021 to 6%. Further, it is stated that the extent of the actual impact will be dependent upon the severity and the duration of this outbreak. Loss of jobs. With an increasing number of coronavirus cases, the government has locked down transportation services, closed all the public and private offices, factories, and restricted mobilization. Based on recent studies, some economists have said that there is a job loss of about 40 million people in the country, mostly in the unorganized sectors. In this scenario, they are predicting that India would go into recession, affecting the unorganized sector and the semi-skilled job holders losing their employment the most. Now, let's take a look at the sectorial impact. Hospitality industry. The National Restaurant Association of India, which represents 5 lakh plus restaurants across the country, has advised its members to shut down the dine-in operations. This will impact operations of thousands of dine-in restaurants, pubs, bars and cafes. By extension, the food delivery platforms such as Swiggy and Zomato that are functioning by itself have also taken a very big hit. The labor sector. The labor sectors are worst impacted as they are not provided jobs due to the lockdown, and most of the labor sectors are associated with construction companies and daily wage earners. The travel restrictions and quarantines affecting hundreds of millions of people have left the Indian factories short of labor and parts, just-in-time supply chains, and triggering sales warning across technology, automotive, consumer goods, pharmaceuticals, and many other industries. Food and agriculture. The food and agriculture sector contributes the highest in GDP, that is 16.5%, and 43% to the employment sector. The major portion of the food processing sector deals with the dairy, that is 29%, edible oil, that is 32%, and cereals, that is 10%. The supply of the food and agricultural products will be affected in the coming seasons due to low sowing of the upcoming seasonal crops, which will affect the operations as said by the Ministry of Agriculture. The e-commerce. The online business in today's economy plays a major role in the economy with a large market share of about $950 billion. It contributes to 10% to the Indian GDP. Amidst the social distancing due to the threat of COVID-19, the tendency of the consumers to overstock on essential products and commodities such as rice, flour and lentils have increased. This gave the rise in sales of the FMCG companies due to the distorted supply chain. The e-commerce sector saw a dip in the growth with pressure on the supply chain deliveries and the expectations of the consumers on the companies to come up with new distribution channels focusing on direct route to the customers. Tourism industry. Movement of people is restricted due to the fears over the spread of COVID-19 and hence the tourism industry is facing a huge loss. Tourists spend money in the countries they visit, so the loss of this money is affecting the economies of many countries. Air travel demand is declined and hence the aviation industry as well as the petroleum industry is negatively affected. Now, let's take a look at some positive outcomes of this situation. Atmanirbhar India. On 12th May, the Prime Minister in an address to the nation said that the coronavirus crisis should be seen as an opportunity, laying emphasis on the domestic products and economic self-reliance through an Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. The following day, the Finance Minister started laying out the details for Prime Minister's vision, which would continue into the next few days. Foreign direct investment is welcome and also the technology is welcome to help India being a bigger and a more important part of the global economy. China plus one. China has become the leading manufacturer of goods in the world, but the economic changes in the country are causing a shift in the thought. For instance, the wages for Chinese workers have tripled over the course of the past few decades. This is causing the manufacturers to move some outsourcing to the countries where the worker wages are still low. As a result, China's economy has been slowing. This is the China plus one strategy. Many companies are adding new operations to Asia's developing countries to supplement current production. Growth in the digital connectivity, infrastructure development coupled with rising household income and increase in India's customer spending makes India the best choice to be the plus one. Increased importance of technology. Above point stated mostly the negative impacts of the lockdown, but we would miss out something if we do not acknowledge the growth of leading digital-infused technological gain. With the advent of the lockdown, most of the sector shifted their functioning online. The MNCs are utilizing their work-from-home option to carry out an uninterrupted working. This present crisis has highlighted the importance of investing in technologies such as cloud data, cybersecurity, self-reliance capabilities, and e-governance. Opportunities for India. Economists are of the opinion that the disruption caused by the virus in China could pave way for more foreign investments in the emerging economies like India, Bangladesh and Vietnam as the world looks to reduce the dependency on China. Experts feel that India has a good chance of becoming an attractive manufacturing hub given the present situation and provided the government changes some of its trade policies to bring down the commodity prices. Efforts taken by the government. The government of India is aiming to attract companies that wish to move out of China or are looking for an alternative to China. The PM's office is conveying to the government, central as well as the state machinery to prepare pro-investment strategies. A total of at least 4 lakh hectares have been embarked for the purpose as reported by the Economic Times. FDI policy. The finance minister notified changes in the FDI rules, making the government approval mandatory for the foreign investment from the country that share border with India to prevent opportunistic takeover of domestic firms amid the COVID-19 pandemic under the Foreign Exchange Management Law. As per the amendment to the FDI policy, any entity or beneficial owner of an investment into India or a citizen based in a country which shares land border with India can invest only under the government route. Now, let's go to the conclusion. Important factors. It is important to understand that the factors that determine the shape of this recovery. These include the overall duration of the pandemic, the effect on the jobs and household incomes, and the extent of the fiscal stimulus provided by the government. Economic recovery. Experts suggest that a V-shaped recovery plan for India would be beneficial. In the second week of May, companies started preparations for restarting the operations. Some companies have opened offices with maximum permitted strength of 33%, while others took a more cautious approach of as low as just 5%. The beginning of June saw companies further reopen and making plans to reopen. The five Indian states, Kerala, Punjab, Tamil Nadu, Haryana and Karnataka are contributing to 27% of India's GDP as India emerges from a total lockdown. By mid-June, the unemployment levels were back to the pre-lockdown levels. A new way of life. Analysis of Google search trends shows that the consumers are shifting consumption patterns as they adapt to a new way of life. The analysis showed that there was a pent-up demand for saloon services, air conditioners, air travels, bikes, vacuum cleaners, and washing machines. Adopting renewable alternatives. India should take this opportunity to increase the support for renewable energy, particularly rooftop solar, through appropriate policies and business models. Decentralized solar power can help spread critical services in the remote regions if the upfront capital constraints can be addressed. Similarly, scaling up the electrification and adoption of public transport will be critically important to reduce traffic congestion and air pollution. This should involve closer coordination with the electricity sector and a greater focus on vehicle charging infrastructure. Regulating the enabling technologies. Finally, it is useful to consider that the future may see a greater employment in the e-commerce sectors as well as in the new technologies that can help support the future response and resilience mechanisms. While supporting with the development of such sectors, it is important to put the right regulations in place to ensure data privacy and customer protection. Thus, we shouldn't let this chance skip and make maximum benefits out of this for developing a sustainable environment as well as a very good economical foundation for 2021. As of now, the economical damage caused by COVID-19 is manageable, but with time, the damage will increase. Hope that the vaccine is developed very soon to prevent the further loss of lives and also the collapse of the economies. Now, let us know your views about this in the comment section below. Thank you.